Until yesterday's session, we have saw about how to. In yesterday's session, we have saw about how to install TestNG, how to write a small TestNG programs. Then we have saw about five annotations: @TestAnnotation, @BeforeMethod, @AfterMethod, @BeforeClass, and @AfterClassAnnotation. These are the annotations what we have saw in the previous session. Now, if you have many @TestAnnotations, if you have many @TestAnnotations, by default it runs in alphabetical order. I don't want to run it in alphabetical order. For example, if you have these methods, these three methods I have: create customer, delete customer, edit customer. Create customer, edit customer, and delete customer. Create customer, delete customer, and edit customer. Create customer, edit, delete customer, and edit customer. Now, if I run this, what will be the output of this program? Click run as TestNG test. Create, delete, edit. Because if you have many @TestAnnotations, it runs in alphabetical order. Create customer, delete customer, edit customer. Now, I don't want to run in this order. I want to run in the same sequence. How can you run in the same sequence? There are different ways how to sequence. One of the ways is using priority. @TestAnnotation can be given priority, and whichever the annotation has least priority, will get executed first. Priority equal to 0, priority equal to 1, and priority equal to 2. Now, if I run this, it will run as per the priority. @TestAnnotation can be given priority, and whichever the annotation has least priority will get executed first. Right click, run as TestNG test. Create customer, edit customer, and delete customer. Create customer, edit customer, and delete customer. Create customer, edit customer, and delete customer. Now, and delete. Because it runs as per the priority. Now, let me have one more. I'm going to make this as modify customer. modify customer. I'll name this as modify customer. Modify customer 1, 2, 5, like this, whichever order. Now I have 4 methods: create customer, edit customer, modify customer, and delete customer. I have given 0, 1, 2, 5 like that. If I run this, right click, run as test ng test, it will run as per the priority. It is not mandatory that I have to give in the same sequence 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. I can skip the sequence also. 0, whichever the annotation has least priority will get executed first. Execution will follow the ascending order of priority. Now, at the rate test is given priority here. See, in real time, this is what we will be using. Most probably we will be using this only. Most probably we will be using this only. At the rate test can be given priority. See, when we are in real time, when we are giving, we will give 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, from 5 to 15, we will give a gap. Again, 5 to 15 or somewhere, we will give the gap. Then again, from we'll start with 16, 17, 18, 19. From 20 to 25, we will give a gap. We will give lot of gaps in between in real time. Do you know why we give that gap? Do you know why we give that gap? Because in future if you are writing some test cases in between, we don't want to change the complete sequence. If you change a little bit of sequence somewhere, it will map. That's why it is better to give the gaps in between. That is what we will be doing here in real time. Okay. Now, let us see some notes for this. Sequencing order of execution using test methods using priority. At the rate test can be given priority, and whichever the annotation has least priority will get executed first. Execution will follow the ascending order of priority. Execution will follow the ascending order of priority. That's it. Take down this. Have you completed this, everyone? Okay. One of the ways using priority, see, while you are executing, due to some or the other reasons, developers has stopped this modify customer. There is some mistake with this modify customer, but even though if you raise a bug to the developer, developer will fix it, tell that, no, we are not going to fix it now, we will fix it later after few days. In that case, what will you do? You don't want to execute this for few days. After few days, you have to execute this. You have to, as of now, you have to ignore it, this particular test methods. Modify customer. In that case, what you can do? If your developer sees any commented lines of code, if your manager sees any commented lines of code, he will remove it. That's not the right way. How will you ignore a test method in TestNG? I can use enabled equal to false. To ignore a test method in TestNG. Now if I run this, only three methods which will run. Sometimes there might be a necessity of this also. See, totally there are four, but when you run that, it will give you the output as only three only. Total test runs three. Create, edit and delete. Execution won't enter inside that at all. How will you ignore a test method in TestNG? We can use enabled equal to false to ignore a test method in TestNG. Take down this. One method, that's enough. Okay, next. Normally, how will you create any TestNG class? Right click on the package, TestNG, create TestNG class. Okay, I'm going to name this as user. Create user. System.out.println. Create user. Edit user. Edit user. And delete user. Delete user. Create user, edit user, and delete user. Run as test NG test. When I run this, create user, delete user, and edit user. Create user, delete user, and edit user. But first, anyhow, create user will get executed. When it tries to run the delete user, before delete user, it has to execute edit user. Before delete user, it has to execute edit user. Create user, delete user, and edit user. Create user. Before deleting user, I want to edit the user. Until unless edit user gets successfully executed, I should not execute delete user. Create user, delete user, before delete user. Create user, delete, before delete user, it has to execute edit user. In that case, depends on methods. Edit user. On methods, user. Create user, edit user, and before executing delete user, it has to execute the edit user. Until unless edit user gets successfully executed. This delete user will not get executed. If one method is depending on another method, until unless the another method gets executed, this one method will not get executed. This is called depends on methods. See, create, edit, and delete. You can ask me, sir, we can use priority itself, right? Yes, we can use priority itself. This is another way, different ways of sequencing. There might be one more method, create. Here I'll have modify also. Modify. User. intermediate user, when it tries to run, sorry, when it tries to run this delete user, before delete user, create user, before delete user, it has to edit user and modify user. It has to edit user and modify user. Create user. When it tries to run delete user, before delete user, it has to edit user and modify user. You can have multiple dependencies also. You can have multiple dependencies also. You can have multiple dependencies or multiple dependencies as well. I can have like this also. First it goes to edit. I can have like this also. First anyhow create user will get executed. After create it will come to delete, but before delete it has to go to edit. Before edit it has to go to modify. Then it will execute modify, edit, delete, and it will come out. In this case, create user, modify user, edit user, delete user, and it will come out. You can have multi-level dependencies also. You can have multi-level dependencies also. Now, see, if I run this, first anyhow create user will get executed. When it tries to run delete user, before delete user, it has to execute edit user. Before edit user, it has to execute modify user. Before modify user, it has to execute edit user. Before edit user, it has to execute modify user. Before modify, there is no end at all here. Make sure when you are giving multi-level dependencies, make sure when you are giving when you are using multi-level dependencies, create user, delete user, edit user, modify user. Create user, modify user, edit. You can have multiple dependencies as well as multi-level dependencies. Both the ways you have. Create user, edit user, modify user. And you can have multiple dependencies as well as multi-level dependencies. Both the ways it is possible. Sequencing execution order using depends on method. Depends on methods can be used to sequence test methods, and depends on methods accepts an array of string which contains the list of methods which the test methods depends on. Take down this. Don't take down this program. Take down our program. Yeah, have you completed this? Next. Until now we are seeing only the success scenarios. Until now we are seeing only the success scenarios. create customer, edit customer, delete customer. Create customer, delete customer, edit customer. This. Now, if I run this, it will run successfully. Sorry, create user, delete user, and create user, edit user, and delete user. Yes. Now, this is a positive case. Create, edit, and delete. Right. Now, I am going to have here string actual equal to ABCD string expected equal to ABCD assert. See, I want to compare both. If both are same, I want to execute the next line of execution, or else I want to throw the error here itself. In that case, what to do? Assert class of testng. Though you cannot go with if else. If you go with if else, right, either if or else will get executed, but I don't want like that. If the condition is false, I have to throw the error here itself. In that case, assert class of testng has assert equals to method actual dot expected. If both are same, it will come to the next line of execution. If both are same, I will come to the next line of execution. Or else it will throw you an error here itself. Let me run this. See, yes. If both are same, actual dot expected, create, delete, edit. Total test runs 3, failure 0, skip 0. Now, what happens if it is different? Run this, right click, run as testng test. See here, total runs 3, failures 1, skip 1. Total runs 3, passed method, create user, failed. Edit user, failed, edit user, and skipped, delete user, skipped, delete user, like this. This is how it will be. Create user, user, and edit user. This is how, if one method is dependent on another method, if another method fails, this one method will be skipped. That is one we have saw. Then we have saw assert class of testng. Which has static assert equals to method. That is static overloaded methods for comparing actual and expected. If both are same, it will come to the next line of execution, or else it will throw you an error here. Assert. We can use assert class of testng, which has list of static assert equals to, static overloaded methods for comparing actual and expected, that is checkpoints. If assertion passes, the test will be marked as pass, and if assertion fails, the test will be marked as fail. If there is any statement after the assert, it will not be executed if assertion fails. Skipping test methods. If you set a test methods to depends on another test methods, and if assertion fails, the dependent test method will be skipped. Okay, take down this. Take down this.